Praise, ladies and gentlemen. Well, you are all aware of what happened as well. We're here. You are aware of the ENSA's protest that was engineered by fake news that came out of Delta State, where the local security outfit called Operation Delta said it was on routine stop and search and patrol when there are questions on two individuals, and out of it, one of them decided to bolt out of the vehicle he was in, and an individual who wanted to spread mischief took video of the incident and then put it on social media that SARS killed somebody, and that led to protests in Delta State. But at the course of investigation, it was found out that nobody was killed and SARS was not involved. But then, with the use of social media, everything went so wide, the essence that Lagos picked it. And when Lagos picked it, it became a serious matter. Lagos became the epicenter of the protest. This ENSA's group that started sometimes in 2017. Now they resuscitated it and then came up with a campaign against ENSA. And when they campaigned against ENSAS, they came with 5 demands. And after about 4 days protests, the authority acceded to those demands because they were demands that would lead to reform of the SARS itself. Our expectation was that after that, they would all go back, they would leave the street. But then, they didn't leave the street. And everybody in this country, every security agent, knows that when people come out to protest without observing the protocol, you stay too much on the street protesting, there's always a tendency of the protest subsequently turning violent. Because some miscreants, hoodlums, will infiltrate the protesters, and at the end of the day, it will become violent. So we engage the stakeholders, we engage civil society organizations, we engage entertainers, musicians, we dialogue and make them to understand that after meeting their demand, they should be off the road, but they did not leave the road. And what happened? We've seen massive destruction of lives and property. We've seen massive destruction of public property. We've seen destruction of police stations. We've seen destruction of businesses. In fact, the Lagos state is the worst. In some states, we saw not only attacks on police stations, but attacks on correctional services. Now, you can imagine, police is the face of government. Anybody that comes into the country, the first hand of authority you meet is the police. And when the police is viciously attacked by hoodlums, miscreants, in this manner that we've seen, the tendency is for the police to be provoked. And when you are provoked, you have the power, you have the capacity, you have the strength to repair these people. But you show restraint, you show maximum restraint by not using maximum force to repair the miscreants, the hoodlums, the criminals that went about destroying properties and killing people here and there. So that resilience that you've shown, you show restraint, has shown that no amount of provocation will lead you to give credence to what they have been preaching of police brutality. So I congratulate you for that resilience. I congratulate you for showing restraint, and that has now turned the table against the protesters. Everybody knows that you are professional in handling the protesters, which subsequently turned violent. 14 states in this country were affected with this incident of violence. And I'm happy to know that not everybody in this country agreed with the amount, with the violent protesters. And not everybody in this country agreed that police is bad. Everybody knows that in every organization, in every institution, in every country, you have some few that are bad. Just like we have few in the police that are bad, the majority of Nigerian police officers are good. Remember what Mr. President said in support of the police. I quote, he said, the vast majority of men and women of the Nigerian police force are patriotic and committed to protecting the lives and livelihood of Nigerians. And we'll continue to support them to do their job. So the Nigerian police has support from the highest authority in this country. So it is not that everybody dislike the police. There are those that are finding it difficult to come out and say openly. But they call always to say, we are behind you. You are doing a good job. Please continue. So despite the fact that you've been attacked, some of us are in the hospital now. Your stations and your residences were attacked and burned. Your personal belongings, your vehicles were destroyed. Still, you became committed to your constitutional duties. You came out and continued to do your policing job in protecting lives and property. So thank you very much for that. As the protests and the violence were going on, you did not sit by. You made sure that a lot of people were arrested. So far, as of 3 days ago, we've arrested 1,596 suspects all over the country as a result of this violence. On the second segment of our discussion, we are going to discuss all the reform initiatives that supports all of us in for us to continue to do the constitutional responsibilities that we've shouldered. All of us have to understand that we are Nigerians, we're special Nigerians. We are special because we are police officers. We are special because we are specially trained to manage Nigerians. So we are not the same. And we are specially trained. That's why we are not easily provoked. And for that reason, we must be treated specially. And I'll tell you how government is treating us specially in the second segment of our discussion. So I would like to stop here and thank you.